Paul Manafort's coats.
Oh, Paul Manafort's coats. Paul Manafort's coats. Paul Manafort's coats. The emperor has new no clothes is going to be rewritten to be the emperor has way too many coats. I don't know.
That is no, but like that's absolutely what's happening right now. Everyone's focusing on like, and we'll show them to you in a second, but everyone's focusing on how ridiculous Paul Manafort's coats are. None of us are thinking of how difficult it must be to be Paul Manafort without these coats.
Honestly, like you just walk around with that much cash to hide. Do you know how hard it is to hide that much cash?
No, I've never had to.
You have to buy these things, $15,000 ostrich coats that look like snakes.
Yeah.
Can we talk about that? You're gonna get into it, right?
Yeah. Let's go quickly. We'll get into the coats. I just wanna kinda, and maybe we'll skip over some of this stuff. But first, Donald Trump's former campaign manager once bought two silk rugs for $160,000. He once spent more than $400,000 in a single year on high-end clothing, and he regularly paid for his extravagant expenses through international wire transfers.
As you do. Western Union.
I don't have any cash. Do you take rubles?
Oh,
so ridiculous.
I'll just wire transfer you this money. Yeah, but obviously this is so, the whole thing is ridiculous. And yes, if this were one Mercedes, who cares?
Right.
If it were, you know, like a, you know, $5,000 shopping spree at Brooks Brothers or whatever the hell, who cares? $15,000 on one coat, $400,000 on clothing. Like if you were like, go, Francesca, go spend $400,000 at Nordstrom Rack, which is where I shop.
Good for you.
Of course, because you don't gotta support the people who don't support Ivanka's brand, mm-hmm. RIP. I wouldn't be able to collect that much in that time.
100%. Let's go to graphic 3 in this. From 2010 to 2012, Manafort spent $324,325 at House of Bijan. Also paying through international wire transfer. For being from California, Bijan has a special place in my heart.
Can you explain what a Bijan is?
So here is a billboard. All of these Bijan billboards are from the corner of Santa Monica. So we'll stop right here for a second.
Okay.
They're from the corner of Santa Monica Boulevard and Sepulveda Boulevard. Here is the spring 1988. That's his Bijan, and those are his kids in 88. Let's go to the next one. There they are, 20 years later.
Oh my.
Bijan. God. And I'm not, you see, they're two different billboards. He has for years, those two billboards are both on the corner. There's one on the northeast side, and this is on the southeast side.
Okay, but neither of those, I got kind of freaked out because the woman looked suddenly like his wife in this photo, but they're his kids.
Yeah.
Okay, 20 years later, can you believe it? Thank you, Paul Manafort. It needs to be a little extra sticker.
So
we should go wheat paste that up there.
There's one more. And so this car, this jet, like it's not just the billboards. This is a store that's in Beverly Hills, and he always parks, that's his yellow Ferrari. He always parks like a Bugatti. This is the gaudiest, most ridiculous over the top.
I think we need to go there. I need to go
field
to Bijan.
Field piece.
We need to do a field piece. You and me, Brett. Let's do it. I'll jump and into the Bucati. What is it called?
The
I don't know.
Bucati. No, the Bugatti. I woke up in a new Bugatti.
I'll jump in the Bucatini.
The Bucatini.
And you just like ask them about their ostrich coats that look like snakes. Why would you buy a coat made out of ostrich if you're gonna make it look like a snake?
Yeah, okay, let's go to the coats. This is graphic 10, I believe. Just here, it starts with like these coats that look like you're in The Sopranos.
The off-centered buttons.
Then the next is here. You know, it just keeps going. That's kind of fine, whatever. Then you get into the busy lining situations.
Ooh, busy lining.
Busy lining is the next one. Yeah, so he likes a good paisley lining.
Sure, this is like, that's like the inside of all of Steve Bannon's coats. Can you imagine, it's like LL Bean on the outside, Armani on the inside. Yeah, now we're getting into more Sopranos for sure. I can't tell whether these coats belong on Sopranos or Seinfeld. Either like, look at that.
So this is, I assume this is the snake one. And the next one is the $15,000. But if you get close, you see. But you get close, you see it has like, it is like chicken skin, but it does from here look like it's made of some kind of reptile.
How much did the ostrich have to suffer? Because if it didn't suffer, I don't want it. I want it to scream.
They're like Bijan, they're like, we would play the sound of the ostrich suffering.
I'll take it. Do you accept wire transfer? Awesome. This is, again, it's just like, I think that's when you launder money though, to be fair, once again, to all the money launderers mm-hmm. out there, you have to put your money in goods because that hides it, I believe.
Right. Yeah.
And it's easier. And then you can sell those goods later. That's why money launderers buy property, because it's something that holds its value, it increases its value, and it's easy to hide your money in it because it's concrete.
Yeah. I just can't imagine. Yeah, the whole idea is he made all this money by doing business with like oligarchs and everything and advocating on behalf of foreign agents, and then he has it and he needs to hide it. But why would you hide it so extravagantly?
Listen,
like, that's nuts.
I think he should have to wear those coats in court. Like, they were talking about how he's not wearing a jumpsuit. It's like, obviously he's not wearing a jumpsuit, you know, an orange jumpsuit. But like, wear the coats. Why not? Just lean in. Which one would you wear, Brett? Like, honestly?
Honestly, if there was a one, I've always wanted to wear, it was the first one we saw, because I always want to look like, if you watch old cartoons, what they would do is they would just take one plaid pattern, and as you moved, the plaid pattern wouldn't move along with you. It was just like you would reveal more of this static plaid pattern.
You just want to be Mr. Magoo goes a night out or whatever. Yes, that's exactly right.
Yeah, someone did Photoshop a photo of what they thought the ostrich coat would look like, and there it is. When I hear ostrich coat, that's what I want.
That's what you were tapping
into.
Thank you so much for watching this video from The Damage Report. Please don't forget to like the video and also to subscribe to the channel so that you get notified as soon as new videos become available. To hear even more about both this topic and other issues not being covered nearly enough by the mainstream media, you're gonna wanna tune in every morning to our full hour-long show. That's at 12 p.m. Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, available on the TYT Network channel on YouTube TV.